What up, everybody? Jay Smalls. I want to talk some basketball today, man, on this rainy-ass day here in Chicago. With official reports out now that Derrick Rose is having non-contact basketball drills, he has officially been ruled out again for the year. It's a good move for the Bulls to get it off paper, especially as nasty as everything got previously with the previous knee injury. But with the meniscus tear that he had and the repair, he could be back this year, ladies and gentlemen. And don't short sell Derrick Rose for being too cautious of coming back and watching out for himself. Look at this realistically. The East is a two top-heavy team league, Indiana and Miami. Miami's the better team. Then you have Indiana, who's trying to find themselves. They picked up Evan Turner, Andrew Bynum, but they still can't find their glitch. They have a glitch. They can't find their gel. And that's what's really hurting them and could hurt them even facing a Bulls team without Derrick Rose in the playoffs, just because of the tenacity that Joe Kim brings, Taj brings, Jimmy Butler. You got Mike Dunleavy tearing it up, DJ Augustine, Kirk Heinrich. I mean, the list goes on. So with that being said, Indiana's got their own worries to fill out here. You only have really Brooklyn and Toronto in that 4 or 5 spot that are hovering with the Bulls. The Bulls right now, even without Derrick, could probably take those teams to 7 games and or win that series. So with that being said, if Derrick did come back, that'd be one of the greatest comebacks as far as notoriety and drama since Willis Reed with the Knicks in the playoffs walking out. Now, he's hitting into the drills today. Yeah, you have about 15 games left in the season. You start getting into contact in about 2 weeks. The Bulls are going to be able to get the 3 seed. So 3 or 4 seed, you're going to play Toronto or Washington. Maybe Brooklyn at worst case scenario. You can beat any of those teams with your team as is. But going into a series later round, the second or third round, and you're going against Miami or Indiana, if Derrick's in full contact practice, I don't see how he could not be some way finagled onto the playoff roster. Being anything, you want to have that chip in the back of your shoulder. I don't know how you wouldn't if you were John Paxson or Tibbs. Even if you have to deal with the question, it's worth it. It's just to have that. Even if he can only come back to a certain avail, just the threat of him being on there will throw people's game plans off and just open up things that you've seen Joe Kim open up and Taj and Jimmy. It's just been crazy. So it's a good thing to see there. We have a lot of exciting ball left to be played here with the playoffs starting. So going into there, we're going to break into the Eastern and Western Conference Finals. Going into there, my predictions pretty much out of the West, San Antonio or the Clippers. Hands down, that's all I see coming out of there. With that, then you have the East, and it's Miami. You know, unless Derrick Rose is coming back or Indiana can find their gel, it's Miami again. And I don't see the Clippers or San Antonio beating Miami Heat. I just don't see it. Only way that happens is a few things have to happen. Dwayne Wade needs to not be playing well. If his knees are really buckling up and causing him some issues, that can cause Miami some down low, outside perimeter issues. Second off, their inside game is just non-existent, so that can be exposed. And then just D-up LeBron how you did last year if you're the Spurs. If you're going to let him beat you, shoot. You're going to kill me, LeBron. You're going to shoot to kill me. So with that being said, peace. This is Jay Smalls. A little tune here. Ride us out. Let's get into the playoffs, baby. All right, D-Rose.
the earth like a comet invasion. Nas is like the Afrocentric Asian, half man, half amazing. Cause in my physical, I can't express through song. Delete stress like Motrin, the next day strong. I drink my wet with Medusa, give a shotguns in hell. From the split that I'm lifting in hell, it ain't hard to tell.